All right, gentlemen, so we are with us head coach of the Jamaica national men's team, Theodore Whitmore, former player, now head coach. We're going to get an opening comment from him on his team's victory tonight, and then we're going to open the floor for a few questions. Coach, obviously you came here, you went away with the victory.
Well, it wasn't all about a win situation. We came here and we wanted to help our Caribbean neighbors in terms of giving them a good practice game going into their two World Cup qualified games, you know, and I think we did just that. The added bonus is just a victory.
Perfect. Opening question for coach.
Coach, tell us about the composition of your squad and what do you think about their overall performance?
Of my team?
Yeah.
Well, I think it was a excellent performance, workmanlike performance, taking into consideration that our players are now in pre-season mode. I think they give a good account of themselves despite the situation this afternoon.
In terms of what you're looking for from this team in particular, of course not the World Cup squad could see, but what are you looking for from these players going forward now?
Well, as I say, we are in a rebuilding process. We're looking forward to 2022. This afternoon we use all local players this afternoon, and as I said before, they give a good account of themselves. We have a couple of players that did not play in the just concluded World Cup squad, and I think they did well with a few of our local base players.
Coach, obviously you said at the start that your purpose here was to give Trinidad a proper exercise. What are your thoughts on the way Trinidad and Tobago look tonight?
Well, yes, I think unfortunately for us, I think the Trinidad team is a pretty decent team, and to be honest, I must say hats off to Dennis and his coaching staff. With just a bit of luck tonight, I think we were really unfortunate, because I think the Trinidad team created numerous chances and just failed to put them away. But the good thing is that Trinidad is getting chances, you know, that's a good part of it.
Yourself and Dennis on the sidelines, two World Cup legends in both your respective countries. How do you feel about seeing Dennis on the sideline and yourself? What do you think that the contribution you could give back to the both teams?
Well, yes, as I say, hats off to Dennis. We have a lot of battle out here on this same pitch, you know, but it's very positive to see Dennis Sturgeon on the other side, knowing that we were up against each other a few years and we are on the sideline. But he's positive, and only hope that the Trinidad FA will believe in their local coaches and support them.
You have any further questions, Coach?
Good.
Coach, thanks a lot. We want to wish you the best odds in your next friendly against Canada.
All right, then. Thanks, sir. All right.
All right, so we have Coach Dennis Lawrence with us here. We go straight off to the questions for Coach.
Do you want to give tonight?
I was a bit disappointed with the first goal we conceded. I thought it was too soft. It's not the way we want to start the game. Then from that, the boys and them did well to get themselves back into the game. I think we had too many chances. We need to start putting away these chances, because at the end of the day, goals win matches. I think some of the chances we had was that clear cut. And then from there on, Jamaica made it very difficult for us. The boys stuck at it. I don't want to talk about the referee. I don't want to talk about it again. And I was pleased in one aspect, but I was disappointed that we lost the game, because as I said, the first goal we conceded, I thought it was too soft, it was too early in the game, and it's not what we're trying to do.
But I understand you have committed on the second goal. Yeah. You thought about it, was it an infringement or what?
No, the second goal, we looked at it on the video clip, it came off the guy's shoulder. I think it was a fair goal. We thought it was handball at the time, so I complimented him on that. At least he got one thing right, but apart from that, I thought he was very poor tonight.
Six questions, coach.
Not about
anybody else?
Yeah.
All right, coach. Yes, you have a good view on the game. Who could have impressed you the most from the team this
year? I thought the boys in general, the two centre backs, Aubrey and Tristan, did very well. Stood up strong. Alvin Jones was very impressive tonight as well. Jared London. So we had a few good performances, but as I said before, I'm more concerned with the fact that how we conceded the first goal. I thought it was a bit too soft. From that, we're trying to climb a hill after that, because we're trying to get back into the game. But fair credit to the boys, they fought, they stuck at it, and we were a bit unlucky not to get the second goal, because we had too many chances and we should have scored the second goal.